Fishing has traditionally been a male-dominated area, but women widowed during the tsunami have had no option but to take over their husband's work. They're helping themselves, but the government has not helped because of a bureaucratic hurdle, and here's a special report 3 years after the tsunami.
An hour's drive from Kadalur takes us to Parangipete, a remote fishing hamlet, a village which has now come to symbolize woman power. After the tsunami, it's the women who have taken up inland fishing, an occupation traditionally considered exclusive to men here. But these women here had no choice. Some had lost their husbands in the tsunami. Others need the income to pay off loans they took to repair boats and nets damaged in the tsunami. But even though these resilient women have managed to tide themselves and their families over the disaster that struck them, the government still doesn't recognize them as the head of their families, denying them access to rehabilitation and relief assistance.
அதனால வந்து ஆனவங்க வாங்கிட்டாங்க, எங்களுக்கு எதுவும் எழுதி கொடுத்து செய்யல. இந்த மாதிரி வந்து கேட்டுட்டு தான் இருக்கிறாங்க, சொல்லிட்டு தான் இருக்கிறோம். எங்களுக்கு அதெல்லாம் செய்யல. இதெல்லாம் பழைய தோணி அடி போட்டு இதெல்லாம் நாங்களா இப்ப விட்டு வச்சு செஞ்சிட்டு இருக்கிறோம்.
While they feel cheated, these women have now given up waiting for the government to help them. They try to make ends meet with the 50 to 100 rupees they earn a day. They have put the past behind them and dream of a better future for their children.
எங்களோடய போயிட்டு இருந்த தொழில் அவங்க வேற ஏதாச்சும் படிச்சுட்டு வேற ஏதாச்சும் வேலைக்கு போட்டு
பசங்க எல்லாம் படிக்க வைக்கணும் போகணும். என்ன செய்ய முடியும்? வேற எங்களுக்கு எதுவும் வருமானத்துக்கு நாங்கள் போகவும் மாட்டோம். இதுதான் எங்களுக்கு அர்த்தம்.
The women here say that it is a difficult job, but they feel equal to the men in this village, in fact stronger. They still mourn the loss of their loved ones, but they have not lost hope and courage, and this is the biggest proof. In Chidambaram, with camera person Sagara Raj, Natasha Raj for NDTV.